Jordan Ellis here, fellow kick MMA. Today I've got with me Anthony Romero, who competes on Dana White Contender Series on the 25th of August. How are you doing?
I'm doing well. Just on my way home from training, and everything's coming together great. So, how are you?
I'm great, thank you. So, you've just been saying you're on your way home from training, so how's that going? You know, obviously you're preparing for the biggest fight of your life, and just wondering how training's changed, and how much notice you've had for this fight?
Yeah, it's good. It's just kind of tapering now. Nothing too intense. All the hard work is done. So just sharpening up on pads, just different situations with my jiu-jitsu coach. Just everything's coming together well.
And just exactly how much notice did you get for this fight? I spoke to a few Contender Series guys who were saying they're getting, you know, a week, 2 weeks. Have you had enough time to prep for this?
Yeah, I've had more than enough time. I could have had like 4 weeks to get ready for this. I had about 10, 12 weeks to get ready. So I knew something big was coming, and I was already in shape before I got the notice. So that wasn't an issue at all. And as soon as I found out I had the opportunity, I just kind of sharpened up on everything, and it wasn't too hard getting into the groove.
Obviously, right now it's a tough time out there for everyone. How has, you know, the whole COVID situation impacted yourself in terms of training and prep and things like that?
Yeah, it's good. Just like small group training. Still working with my coaches. I have certain partners, and everything is well. Nothing too hard. Everything's opening up again. Kind of seeming like normal a little bit. But other than that, nothing's really changed. At the beginning, it was a little bit rough. I was only training with my brother, which he helped me a lot. But other than that, everything is like it used to be.
Okay. And it's up next to this Dana White's Contender Series. It's a massive platform. It's a big chance for yourself so early on in your career. How are you feeling, you know, leading up to it? You're excited, you're nervous, a bit of both?
I'm excited. I'm nervous. I'm not afraid to admit it. I don't know who's not nervous to be on TV and in front of everyone, your family and all that. So I'm not scared to admit that. But the one thing that's different is I know how to deal with the nerves. I'm used to it. I've competed on big shows, world championships. So I'm not too afraid about that. So I'm just really excited to perform and take advantage of the opportunity that I have. It's a big opportunity that not a lot of people have, and I want to take all of it in and just enjoy the whole process.
And as you said, it is a big opportunity, but it's about more than just winning this. You could win and potentially still walk out without a UFC contract. So is that extra pressure heading in, knowing that you've got to go and impress Dana White, and you probably, you know, maybe got to get a finish or a really dominant display?
Yeah. I think it's one goal at a time, right? I need to make sure that I win the fight for sure, make it decisive. But I don't want to think too far ahead, right? Everyone wants to get a contract. Some people, sometimes Dana White's very likes to give everything, so he'll give like all five people, and that's a bonus. But either way, I know one way or another I'm going to get into the UFC, whether it's winning and not getting a contract or getting a short notice fight. So I'm not thinking too much about doing something to get the contract. I'm more concerned about winning the fight and making it look dominant.
And is the no crowd thing, is that going to be an issue for you? Obviously, you just said you were fighting in, you know, pretty big shows, and now you're coming to a bigger show, but there's going to be no crowd. How's that going to be?
I'm excited. It's going to make me feel comfortable just listening to my coaches. It's really difficult when there's a lot of people there cheering you on, different people giving you advice who aren't even in your corner. But now that I know that I'm going to be hearing just my coaches, it's going to feel really, I guess, relaxing. And that's going to feel like just training at the gym, a little bit more intense. But yeah, it's going to feel like just being at home. So I'm excited. I'm really excited for it.
Good. And I like to ask this question to all the Contender Series guys. Obviously, you're coming from the regional scene, and you've got a brilliant record, and you want to watch. But if people who don't watch outside of the UFC and Bellator and the big shows, they might not know you. So I want to just give you the platform to, you know, tell the fans a bit about yourself, what we can expect on fight night, and you know what you're going to bring.
Yeah, I'm an exciting fighter. You never know what you're going to get, if it's a pure dominance in the whole fight, or if it's a knockout or a submission. But I'm there to put on a show. I'm not too much of a show-off fighter, like someone who likes to talk a lot. I'm kind of to myself, but when I get the opportunity to talk, then I will. But obviously, never to offend someone or anything like that. So I'm kind of to myself. I like to be happy. If you follow my Instagram, I put a lot of smile. It's Monday and all that. So I like to keep a good attitude, and I'm just excited for this opportunity.
Oh, good. And the opportunity is coming soon, and it's against Mike Breeden. I just want to know what you know about your opponent.
He's good all around. I've seen videos here and there of his fights, but I don't really get addicted to it. I don't watch it every day, every night, or anything like that, because I think when I found out who I was fighting, my coaches talked to me about some things that that they see. And other than that, I know he's a great fighter. He's on the show for a reason. They don't just pick anyone from the street. They pick the top prospects in the world to go on this show. And I'm expecting a great fight with him. He's going to bring everything he's got, because I'm sure he wants a contract too. He's not just there to show up. So I'm just excited to test my skills against someone else who's at the top of their game.
So you said you don't watch a lot of tape, or it's not something you're obsessive over, but you watched enough to, you know what his strengths and weaknesses are, and if you can tell me then.
Yeah, he's pretty good standing up. That's where he wins most of his fights. But he's an MMA fighter, right? He's not someone who is good at striking and then you're just going to take him down really easy. He's going to give you a hard time. Just mixing it up. He does well, but other than that, he's just another fighter with a face, and there's always a way to beat somebody, and me and my coaches have been working on it, and we're going to expose that on the 25th, so yeah, he's a great, great fighter all around, but there comes a time where you meet someone, and that will be the day, so.
So on fight night, I'm sure you've imagined it. How do you see your hand getting raised? What is your route to victory in this fight?
Yeah, I see my hand getting raised. I've been saying submission, but it can end any way I want in this fight. It can just be a dominant performance. It can be a submission or a knockout. He's lost by knockout before. He's lost by submission in his amateur career. But other than that, I know he's a new fighter every time he gets in there. So the results can change at any moment. We saw in the last contender series, or like the last episode, the main event, the guy was winning the whole fight, and then he gets picked up, slammed, and he dislocates his elbow, right? So you never know what can happen in there. You might have a plan, and then you might have to change it 360. So I'm just ready for whatever he brings at me. So
okay, well, good luck with it all. That's everything from me, unless you've got anything to add.
Just tune in August 25th. I'm excited to put a performance for everybody. I believe you can check it on ESPN Plus, TSN 2, or Fight Pass. So make sure you tune in, and yeah,